That's such a pretty name. I like that name.
Thank you.
You just walked out to your 1999 hit Man, I Feel Like a Woman, mm-hmm. which is a very... It's a female empowerment song. Mm-hmm. Very, very strong woman up there with I Am Woman, Hear Me Roar, that type of song. So, but you've described yourself as shy. So where did this come from?
Yeah, where does the shy come from?
Yeah.
I am just quite a shy person. I'm a very solitary person. I spend a lot of time alone, and I think this is where I'm the most creative. Uh-huh. When I get out on stage and I get to be with some lovely ladies like you, of course, I get all... I come out, I come out of myself a little bit more.
You want backup singers?
That's it! No, I enjoy interaction. Actually, to be honest, to put it in a nutshell, I do spend a lot of time alone.
Yeah.
I write alone. I just need a lot of alone time. I reflect a lot. So when I am out with other people, it's a moment where I really do embrace the communication and the interaction. That's really the...
I heard that when you were a kid, though, you were a tomboy, yes?
Very much a tomboy. I spent a lot of time in the...
Oh, there you go.
I think my parents wished I was a boy. They always dressed me in blue, and this, check out the haircut. And I did, and people thought I was a little boy. And I acted like a little boy. I was always out hunting with my dad and chopping
wood
and
doing all kinds. Where did you grow up again?
Northern Ontario in Canada.
Oh.
Well, so I was always roughing it.
It was so great to have you backstage at the Red Dress Collection Fashion Show.
What a great...
You were so... She walked up first, and I was right behind her, and I was like, are you nervous? She's like, no, I'm good. I was like, I'm so nervous!
You asked me that twice, actually.
I did,
yes!
I was so nervous.
You're not nervous?
That looks like a really shy outfit.
I know!
And you've also performed at the Super Bowl in 2003.
Yes.
You have this signature sort of sex appeal, and I was wondering what you thought about J-Lo and Shakira's performance, because some critics are actually saying it was too sexy, which I don't know. I didn't see that, but a
not
lot of people
sexy.
Are saying that.
No, they wore it well. They're out there showing what a healthy, strong, confident woman looks like.
That the criticism that J-Lo didn't have enough clothing on. I was like, but it's like...
She has more than Shakira has.
Yeah, I was surprised at that. I didn't know it's because she has a bigger bottom. I was confused by that.
Girl, if I looked like J-Lo, I'd be in a fig leaf and two coconuts.
Walking through life. I didn't get it, but...
These are professional... You know, dancers, movers, performers, entertainers, they know what they're doing. They're not up there to let it all hang out in the sense that they're showing off. They're doing a performance. They're actually dressed from, really from head to toe if you look closely enough, which I'm sure a lot of people try to do, but anyway, they were awesome, I thought.
They were awesome.
Stunning.
Yeah.
And I gotta say, a very proud moment. For the Hispanic community.
Absolutely.
Because of the symbolism.
It was awesome.
Absolutely. Yeah. That Puerto Rican flag, man, I thought my mother was gonna just lose her voice for the next month.
Well, you have many fans of all generations everywhere, clearly. Interesting fan is Post Malone is an absolute mega fan of yours, and he went viral for rocking out to your performance at the American Music Awards. We have a clip of it. In her music videos, she's imitating, you can see it right here, Halsey. So you clearly are influencing so many artists coming up. What's your reaction to all of this?
Well, I'm flattered by all of this, and it's funny because at my concerts, I have such a diverse audience. And a big part of my audience are college-age kids in their 20s who were six when I first came out. So now they're grown up, and they're Halsey and Post Malone and Justin Bieber and it's this age group and you know, so the artists are voicing it and they're sharing their appreciation.
Post
so I'm
Malone
very flattered.
Living his best life listening to you sing.
Talking about your diverse audience, you just announced that you are extending your Vegas residency. December. I'm gonna wear one of those leopard onesies.
Oh yeah, come on.
And today is actually a very special day for you, because
yes.
It is the 25th anniversary of one of your Grammy Award-winning albums.
It Tell is. Us what it means.
You say that your show is a girls let your hair down type of show. What does that
yes.
mean?
Yes. Well, it's everyone let their hair down kind
so
of
good.
Show. Oh yeah, no, this is.
Oh, I love that.
It's a fun show. It's high energy. It's sexy.
Oh, that works in Vegas,
doesn't
yeah.
it?
Oh,
yeah.
She
yeah.
had some of
See,
those
I
dancers
it.
At the run at the Red Dress Collection.
I did.
They looked good.
They're athletic. Oh, look at the girls. They're just having so much fun. It is a fun show. It's very interactive. I bring people up on stage.
Wow.
We do some dancing up there, and we all sing
we
together.
Should go
it's
to that.
Very informal and fun, and just have a party.
Well,